Notion recently announced their 3.1 update, and in this video, I wanted to cover all of the latest features so you know exactly how to implement them into your own workspaces. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's dive right in. The first update that I wanted to share with you all is about AI meeting notes. In the sidebar, you'll now see a meetings section where you can click here to add new AI meeting notes. And when you're in this tab, you'll notice your upcoming meetings at the top, and then you'll see a list of all of your AI meeting notes in here as well. And you can see them all in one place. What I really like about this is that now you can actually filter through all of your meeting notes based on things like attendees, last edited time, and so on. And you can also change the groupings as well, just like a Notion database. So I really like the way that this is getting integrated as part of Notion itself. And another really nice update is that if you click one of these open, you'll notice now that there's these markers next to the summaries where you can see exactly what part of the transcript that it's referencing. So if I click here, you can see that transcript there. I definitely hope that there will be even more updates to this in the future. For example, I would love to have a speaker recognition, but I think that this is great that it's constantly improving. Next, there's been updates to the AI agent. One of the biggest ones is that you can now summarize comments. Seems to be able to read and summarize comments inside of Notion pages. The other updates to AI agent is that you can now have Notion AI look through your private Slack conversations as well as connected to Notion Calendar and Google Calendar. So if you click connect apps, you'll see the new connectors that you can add. So for example, Notion Calendar, Google Calendar, you can all add those and be able to analyze them using the AI agent. With the Slack as well, you can see here that I have private conversations connected too, so I can also look through those if I need to. And one other update is that you can attach CSV files. So if you want Notion AI to transform your CSV file into a Notion database, that's totally possible as well. And that's one of the best use cases. And also one of the previous limitations when the AI agent first launched. So I think this is a really great step forward. I'm excited to see what other new features Notion adds to the AI agent. The next update is Map View. This was included in Notion's 3.1 update announcement, but I've actually covered this already in a dedicated video, so be sure to check that. I will leave a link to that in this video. But basically, Map View allows you to create a new type of database view, which is called Map View. And it consists of various locations using a property called Place. So let's say that you have a travel planner and you want to mark locations, you can do that with Map View. I can click the add pin here and then just place that anywhere on this map. Or what I can do is, for example, use a table view database like this. And I already have a place property, but if you want to add your own place property, you can select type here for place and add your place there as well. The place property allows you to actually add location addresses into your Notion databases. So for example, let's say that I want to go to Paris, then I can put that in there. And if I now click my map view, I can see that pin show up here. So map view can be really useful for travel planners, restaurant trackers, and even employee databases where you might want to see where everyone's located. So I highly encourage you to try out this database view. Next, we have a conditional color update. So you can now use your relations, rollups, and also formulas in order to determine the conditional colors. So as an example, if you wanted to use this feature, for example, you could have a database inline for tasks. So let's say these are tasks and you have a date here for that, and then you have like a status as well. And then let's say that you have a projects database. So again, I'm just going to add an inline database like this. And let's say that this is a projects database. You add a relation to your tasks. So I'm going to go ahead and relate that to the tasks here with the two-way relation. So let's say that there's a web design project. You assign task 1, task 2, and you assign the projects to these tasks. If you wanted to know whether any of these tasks are overdue, you might need to use a formula. So for that, I would use a formula which then checks whether or not they're overdue tasks. So I'm going to do overdue tasks. And then here's a formula where it's going to check if the date is in the past and whether or not the status is done. And if the length of those tasks greater than zero, meaning that there is an overdue task in there, it's going to show the message overdue. So as you can see, let's say that I have one overdue task, then it's going to do that. So in this scenario, what you might want to use is a conditional caller that would turn this into red if there are any overdue tasks in here. And now you can do that by clicking here, add a color setting, and I can actually use the formula for overdue tasks. And if that's overdue, then I want the color to be a red background. Next, we have a card update. And this one wasn't in the official 3.1 announcement, but I think that it's pretty much rolled out to everyone's workspaces. So if you click the settings here and you go to the property visibility, let's say that I have a lot of properties here that I want to display. As you can see, Notion has always displayed these in a stacked format from top to bottom like this, and it can sometimes take up a lot of space on a page. What you can now do is if you go to layout, you can change it to compact, and it's going to reduce the amount of lines in here, which can be really useful depending on the type of properties that you want to display. So for this one, for example, you might not need them all stacked like it was before. Could look really nice if you choose to use this kind of compact format for your card layout. And if you click the compact card settings, you can also choose which one should have a full inline display. So this is very customizable. For example, if it's confusing to have the created time like this, you can still do something like this, where it would have its own full line. So I'm really excited to dive into this card setting. Whenever there's this kind of visual update, I'm really excited. This is definitely going to make a lot of the Notion cards a lot more customized. Next, we have a Notion calendar update. For Notion calendar, if you are adding an event, for example, from a calendar view database inside of your Notion, you can now type in a description through here. So description, that's going to get reflected in your Notion page. So this reduces the need to switch back and forth even more between your Notion calendar and your Notion workspace. So as you can see, this is the new page that I added, and you'll be able to see the description here. Next is a Notion API update, which allows you to create pages with a specific database template. You can already see this in action in, for example, Zapier. So if you're creating a new data source template, you can see there's this template mode here, and I can choose no template, use the default template, whatever that's selected, or you can even choose the template here. And then you would be able to select which template you want to use for this specific automation workflow. The other thing is when you do decide to use a template, then for example with Zapier, you're not going to be allowed to add anything in the content fields because that's now determined by the database template. What I'm hoping for with this update is that potentially Notion AI is going to be able to create pages using specific database templates. I think that would be really exciting. That's what I'm hoping for. Next, I wanted to cover a few more additional updates. There's now a Figma and Notion MCP integration. So what that means is that you could use a Notion product requirements doc to build a prototype in Figma. So if you are a Notion and Figma user, this could be very exciting. The other thing is that there are reaction notifications. So if you are in the sidebar here and someone uses an emoji reaction, you're going to see that pop up here. So what that looks like is something like this. And I think this is a really fun update. The next one is that now if you are on an enterprise plan, you're allowed to define allowed IP addresses. So what that means is that, for example, if you have various offices and people should only be able to access the workspace through specific networks, then you're able to set those up. But again, this is for enterprise users only. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to check the links in the description if you're interested in any of my Notion services, templates, or courses. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.